Hello students, welcome back to the second video on the unit number 4 part B of PECD. In the last video we talk about the selection of motor power rating and thermal loading on the machine. In this video we will talk about the thermal model of motor for heating and cooling. Learning outcomes for this session are: at the end of this video lecture you will be able to derive expressions for the thermal model of motor for both heating and cooling. Also you will be able to solve some numericals related to this topic. So let us start. Due to the complex geometrical shapes of motor and the use of heterogeneous materials during manufacturing, an accurate prediction of the heat flow and the temperature rise inside an electric motor is very difficult. Heterogeneous materials means materials consisting of elements with the different properties. However, the conductivity of these various materials do not differ by large amount. Hence, the machine body can be assumed as a homogeneous. Using this assumption, simple thermal model of the machine can be obtained. With this assumption, this model cannot be said as a perfect model, but this is a good enough for a drive engineer to select a motor rating for a given application, ensuring temperature in the various parts of the motor body do not exceed safe limits. So let us consider a machine with following parameters. At any particular time instant t, where P1 is heat developed in joules per second or watt, P2 is heat dissipated to the cooling medium, joules per second, W is weight of the active part of the machine in kg, small h is specific heat in joules per kg per degree centigrade, capital A is a cooling surface meter square, small d is a coefficient of heat transfer or specific heat dissipation, joules per second per meter square per degree Celsius, and theta is a mean temperature rise in degree Celsius. During a time increment dt, let the machine temperature rise be d theta. That means when a temperature is changing by dt, when the time is changing by dt, temperature changes by or rises by d theta. So using this following heat balance equation, heat absorbed or stored in the machine is equal to heat developed inside the machine minus heat dissipated to the surrounding cooling medium, we can write following expression number 1, that is W into H into d theta is equal to P1 dt minus P2 dt. Now the heat dissipated to the cooling medium, that is this P2, is represented by theta into d into A. Substituting this value or this equation 2 into equation 1, we can get WH into d theta is equal to P1 dt minus theta dA into dt. Now let us define C, which is a product of W into H and termed as thermal capacity of the machine in watts per degree Celsius. And d is the product of small d into A, that is heat dissipation constant in watts per degree Celsius. So by using these C and D, equation number 3 is changed to equation number 6. C d theta is equal to P1 minus d theta whole multiplied by dt. Now again, writing C d theta upon dt is equal to P1 minus d into theta. Now this equation 7 can be represented into equation 8, where we are writing d theta upon dt plus d upon c into theta is equal to p1 upon c. Now here you can see that equation number 8 is a first order differential equation. Now for this equation, we will have to find out the general solution and the particular solution. The general solution is also called as a transient solution, and particular solution is also called as a steady state solution. Now general solution is given by making the constant term, this term p1 upon c, as 0. So if you make this term as 0, and you can write d theta upon dt plus d upon c into theta is equal to 0. So this is a standard representation as dy by dx is equal to minus ax. So y is equal to k e raised to minus at, which is represented here as theta t is equal to k e raised to minus t upon tau. Now this small t represents transients. Theta t is transient temperature. Now tau is a time constant. We are talking about the thermal model of motor for heating. That's why this is heating time constant or thermal constant. So tau is C upon D. Particular solution is obtained by solving following equation. This equation is taken, and once we solve this equation, we can get theta is equal to P1 upon C divided by D upon DT plus D upon C. Now this P1 upon C is a constant term which is independent of time. That's why D upon DT can be taken as 0. Now I'm sorry that this page is not very much clear, but still we can read it. So P1 upon C is independent of time. So D by DT can be taken as 0, and theta S, now this S stands for steady state. So theta S is given by P upon D. So the overall solution to the equation number 8, overall solution for the equation number 8 is given as theta is equal to theta t plus theta s, theta due to steady state and theta due to transient. So p1 upon d plus k e raised to minus t upon tau. The value of k is determined by substituting the initial condition. Now what is the initial condition here? At t is equal to 0, let us assume that theta is equal to theta 1, where theta 1 is the initial temperature rise at t is equal to 0. So by substituting this initial condition in the equation number 15, you can see that theta is replaced by theta 1. This t is made as 0, so this term will be 1. So p1 upon d plus k, from this you can calculate k as theta 1 minus theta s. Now this k unknown is substituted in equation number 15 to get the final expression as theta is equal to theta s plus theta 1 minus theta s whole multiplied by e raised to minus t upon tau, which further simplified to get theta is equal to theta s in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus t by tau plus theta 1 e raised to minus t by tau. This expression is the thermal model of motor for heating. Now let us see the expression for thermal model of motor for cooling. Cooling means when the load on the motor is removed. So let the load on the motor is thrown off after its temperature rise reaches a value theta 2. Heat loss will be reduced to small p1 dash and cooling operation of the motor will begin. Now the value of heat dissipation for d dash, if the time is measured from the instant the load is thrown off, then we can get this expression. C d theta upon dt is equal to p1 dash minus d dash theta. Solving this first order differential equation in the similar manner with the initial condition as theta is equal to theta 2 at t is equal to 0 gives this expression. Theta is equal to theta s dash in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus t by tau dash plus theta 2 e raised to minus t upon tau dash. This expression is derived in the similar manner as that of the expression for the thermal model of motor for heating. The only change is theta s dash tau dash. Theta s dash is p1 dash upon d dash, that is steady state temperature rise for new condition, and tau dash is new time constant, that is cooling time constant. Tau is heating time constant and tau dash is cooling time constant. Now if the motor is disconnected from the supply during cooling, then P dash is equal to theta S dash is equal to 0. So in that case, the equation 19 is reduced or changed to theta is equal to theta 2 e raised to minus t by tau dash. So we have seen three expressions: expression 1 for the thermal model of motor for heating, expression 2 is thermal model of motor for cooling, and then the model of motor for when the supply is made zero. So summarizing the above discussions, when the motor starts with the initial temperature theta 1 at T is equal to 0, then its temperature is given by this expression. When the motor load is thrown off with temperature theta is equal to theta 2, then new temperature is given by this expression. And if the motor is disconnected from the supply, then theta is equal to theta 2 e raised to minus T upon tau dash. Both heating and cooling time constants, tau and tau dash, are dependent on the respective heat dissipation constants, that is D and D dash, which in turn depend on the velocity of cooling air. The variation of the motor temperature rise with the time during heating and cooling is given below. Here on the y-axis we have theta, on the x-axis we have time, and this is a graph for heating and this is the graph for cooling. It must be noted that thermal time constant of a motor are far larger than the electrical and mechanical time constant. Electrical and mechanical time constants have typical values in the range of 1 to 100 milliseconds and 10 milliseconds to 10 seconds. I repeat, for electrical, time constant is 1 to 100 milliseconds. For mechanical, time constant is 10 milliseconds to 10 seconds, and thermal time constant may vary from 10 minutes to couple of hours. So this is all about the thermal model of motor for heating and cooling. Now let us see a small numerical on this. This is a solved numerical from the textbook. Problem is, a motor operates on a periodic duty cycle in which it is clutched to its load for 10 minutes and declutched to run on no load for 20 minutes. Minimum temperature rises 40 degrees Celsius. Heating and cooling time constants are equal and have a value of 60 minutes. When load is declutched continuously, the temperature rise is 15 degrees Celsius. Now we have to determine the maximum temperature during the duty cycle and temperature when the load is clutched continuously. Now here we have just listed what is given to us. Since it is mentioned that cooling and heating time constants are same, tau and tau dash is equal to 60 minutes. When the load is on T1, that duration is 10 minutes, and when the load is off, that duration is 20 minutes. Here it is shown graphically, clutched to the load, that is on time or T1, and this is no load, that is T2. 0, 10, and this actually should be 30, not 20, so that this 10 to 30 will be 20 minutes. When the load is continuously declutched, temperature rise is 15 degrees Celsius, that is theta S dash is given as 15 degrees Celsius. Minimum temperature rise is 40 degrees Celsius. Here it is shown minimum initial value 40 degrees Celsius. This is maximum value. If we refer this graph, this is heating. So during this heating, we will have a curve like this with a minimum value as 40. And here we need to calculate this maximum value. It must be noted that for periodic load, temperature at the end of cycle will be same as at the beginning of the cycle. So if I extend this curve, I can get something like this up to this 40. So when I go to this value, this actually should be 30. Please note that this 20 should actually be 30. So if I extend this line here, so here I will get 30 minutes. So your graph for cooling will go like up to 30 minutes, and the temperature will be 40. So it must be noted that periodic load temperature at the end of cycle, at the end of cycle means here at 30 minute, will be same as that of the beginning of the cycle. So at the beginning we have 40, so here also we should have 40. So using equation of heating, we can write heating means for this part from 0 to 10. So we need to write theta 2 is equal to theta s 1 minus e raised to t1 upon tau plus theta 1 e raised to minus t1 upon tau. So when it is heating, we will use tau and theta s. And if it is cooling, then we will use theta s dash and tau dash. So putting values here, theta 2 is equal to theta s in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus 10 upon 60 plus 40 e raised to minus 10 upon 60. Solving this, we will get theta 2 as 0.1535 theta s plus 33.86. Now similarly, during cooling, the equation becomes 40 is equal to 40. So at the end, of this half cycle, from this maximum value to this value, as I said, this should be 40. So that's why here it is 40 is equal to theta s dash in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus t2 upon tau dash plus theta 2 e raised to minus t2 upon tau dash. So here we know the value of theta s dash as it is given. T2 also we know, tau dash also we know, theta 2 we have calculated here. Substituting these values, we can calculate theta s. And with this theta s, with this value of theta s, which will be substituted here, you can get theta 2. So this is the value of theta 2. So we need to calculate theta 2 and theta s, that is calculated here. Now this is one more problem, that is unsolved problem from the textbook. I suggest you to solve this example. It should be solved in the same manner, and answers for this numerical are given here for the part A and part B. So this is all about the thermal model of motor for heating and cooling. In this short video, we have seen how to derive the expressions for the thermal model of motor for both heating and cooling, and also when it is disconnected from the supply. At the same time, we have seen how to solve a numerical related to this topic, and this is enough for this video. Next time we will talk about classes of motor duty. And till that time, goodbye.